All right, so just take a look at the screen. Here's a little bit of a demo on how to take an original corporate logo design, etc., and take it from there to here. All right, some of the obvious choices are that the L and the E already match up. So if you have letters that are the exact same, good luck. You know, you're going to use them right over again. All right. So here, let's take it from the ground floor, meaning right from the beginning. I'm going to take a blank sheet of paper and lay it right on top. All right. Now, in just a second, I'm going to use the light table here to illuminate some things for you. Do you remember back to when you were younger and you started to learn to write? You had paper that was lined like this?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool thing is, the first step you're going to do is use this idea on your design. So I am going to take, let's add some light to it so you can see, a ruler, and I want to make a line that defines the top of my letters, and I want to make a line that defines the bottom of my letters. Now, if you have only all capitals like I do, you're going to have two lines. If you have a mixture of uppercase and lowercase, you're eventually going to have another line possibly somewhere through here. All right, anytime people are designing letters, you have a framework or somewhere within your working. All right, so for this one, the last thing I'm going to do is find out my letters are angled. So in between, roughly, I'm going to start putting in these angled lines so that by the time I'm done, let's drop the light. Okay, you can see my framework where the letters are going to fit in. Now, if I had to continue, then you're going to draw some more spaces this way. So far, so good? All right. So now we get a place with which we can fit our letters. I luck out because I can use the L and the E right away. So we're going to take these and immediately trace them. All right, piece of cake. Now, looking at these letters, where do you think I could possibly get the B from?
The side.
Yeah, I agree with him. Luckily, it happens to be the next letter. If I take this part right here and close it off near the top, right here, and continue around, now I have the outline of the B. Come on, light, come back. And I can take this little piece right here, and this little piece right here. Okay, so the G now became a B for me. Oddly enough, the O is going to be an A very, very soon, because I can take this part right here, connect it and round it down to the bottom. Now remember, I have my guidelines at the top and the bottom of the letter, so both the left and the right side of this need to come down to the bottom. Now we need to adjust it a little bit. Some of it is some guesswork. Like where I'm putting this arc right now can change. I might put it a little lower, might put it a little bit higher. All right. So I think the important things to ask yourself at the end are, what are my letters doing? And maybe make a little bit of a note. If my letters are angled, but they are also rounded, then each time you design a new letter, ask yourself if they are both this way. So my new letters that I've created, are they angled? Yes, because I have my guideline. And are they rounded? Yes. All right. If you follow your rules through that way, it should work out all right.
For the N, can't you just move the O back one and then just use what the beginning of the, no, forward one? Then use the beginning of what you did for the A as the N?
Yeah, but I would probably try and steal it from the L, because of the nature of the N having the angle at the beginning. So let's go ahead and start by stealing this. Now remember again, this is a rough draft. So you can draw on it, you can mess it up, you can add different details to help yourself out. Because what I'm gonna do first is take this and I'm gonna draw an N right in place. Now I have a little thing that I can guide from. And if I take this piece and scoot it over a little bit more, some of it is also trial and error. You might try one that doesn't work. You need to sneak something else.
If if I were to do BQ, could I just do an EG?
Let's do a little bit of erasing, and then...
Yeah. I feel like I can get through this.
Okay.
Like, I'm just so bad at tracing.
What was your preferred learning style? Were you kinesthetic?
Yeah.
Or were you visual?
I was kinesthetic.
Okay, then it's going to work better when you have this stuff in your hands and you're ready to go.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah, once you've seen it, once you have to go reenact it, it should work out better. Okay? Questions? So here's what we need to do. We need to make sure that we pick a logo today.